England and across the United States, probably even the moon. He's done shows for the Chicago White Sox. He's done the Country Music Association, and twice he's performed for the White House. Say, ooh. You should, because that's pretty impressive. So we're excited to have Tim here with us tonight. He is an awesome magician. Please help me welcome Tim Hennig!
Let's try something. All of us together, everybody give me one thumb up. Give me two thumbs up, thumbs down, cross your hands, open your hands, clasp your hands. We'll give you thumbs so I can see that they're down. A little higher there for me, bud, so I can see. All right, keep your hands together, wiggle them. Let me see that those are down. Hold them a little higher just so I can see. Good. Keep your hands together. Do exactly what I do. I hear some murmuring. If you got stuck, go like this. Yeah. Hey, now I know what some of you were thinking before we got started. You were thinking, is this going to be any good? Is this guy going to be any good? But I want you to know something. While I was waiting to start, I was thinking the exact same thing. I was wondering if my audience was going to be any good, and that's you guys. So I tell you what, I'm going to give you a little test. If you pass it, great. In fact, it's going to be pretty simple. I have some cards here, and these are really big cards. For those in the back, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, look at the little guy with the cards. No, these are like super-sized cards. And whenever you see a magician or somebody like me with cards like this, there's usually a secret move. In fact, I'm going to kind of show you what I'm talking about. It's normally with the ace, the red card. I'll show you the secret move. I'm going to slow it down a little bit. Here we go. Yeah. Did you? Thank you. Thank you. Did you see me put it down there? Well, if you did, you missed it, because the ace is still up here. That's the two. Oh, wait. That was the audience test part. See, if I do anything tonight that's even remotely exciting, I want everyone to take your fist, pump it in the air, and you'll all shout out, Tim, that's amazing. Let's all try that.
Tim, that's amazing.
That was pretty good. But you know what? Let's try it again. In fact, this time, I'm going to make it a little bit easier to follow the ace. I'm going to lift it up a little bit, maybe a little bit higher. That way you can tell from the front or the back where the ace is. You can be sure that that's the one I'm putting down here. So we put the ace down. Yes, I did. We put the ace. You go home. All right. Did you see me put it down there? Well, then you missed it, because that's a two and a three. That's the ace. Everybody pump your fist. Shout it out. Yeah, you are showing potential. You know what, though, I can tell. In fact, that guy in the red hoodie back there, standing back there, he's not even listening to me. He's talking about in the red. Yeah, I didn't get anything from you. What's your name? He says it doesn't matter. We're going to work on your self-esteem. You do matter. To God. All right. Yes. All right. Are you a little bitter about having to exercise at 10:30 at night? All right. Dr. Phil says let it go. All right. And I know from where you're sitting with three cards, it's kind of hard to tell whether I'm taking one or two. So you know what? We're going to make it a little bit easier. Let's just use two of them. The ace is on top. If I go like this, is it on top or bottom? Bottom. How about now? Top. Most of you say, all right, how about now? Everybody says top? Bottom? It's neither. That's the two and the three. That's the ace. Everybody pump your fist, shout it out. I even got you to do it back there. That's awesome. Let's try something. There we go. Ha ha. Hey, take a look at my picture. Oh, thank you. Hey, I want to pick somebody for something we're going to do. In fact, what I'm going to do, I want to get somebody at random. So I'm going to throw out an object into the audience, and whoever catches it, a bowling ball. I have this brick. No. I have this. I want to get somebody completely at random. There we go. Oh, that guy. What's your name? Mick. It didn't hurt when I threw it to you, did it? Mick, even if it hit in the head, it wouldn't have hurt. You know why? It's a soft drink. Mick, toss it back up here to me on the count of three. Whenever you're ready, Mick. Just throw it whenever you feel ready. And actually, Mick, I think I will have you help me with a demonstration. But it's not going to be with the can. It's going to be with this bottle of water. Mick, I know before the kids were playing Sing Maze, you like games? Good. We're going to play a little game. It involves the bottle of water, and I have some cups. And Mick, who are you sitting next to there? Hannah? Your name's Hannah? I always spell that backwards. Yeah. All right. Hannah, don't help Mick, okay? Mick, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pour some of this water into one of these cups, and then you're going to have to keep track of where the water is, all right? Everyone's going to see, but you're going to be like the mouthpiece of the audience, all right? So just kind of pay close attention, Mick. Don't help Mick. Here we go. I'm living dangerously. All right, Mick. Which cup contains the water? Is it in the cup furthest from me, closest to me, or in the middle? Mick? Closest. I like that. You have a mind your own. You were paying attention. There it is. He got it. Give him a hand for that. But Mick, it gets tougher. This time, I shall rearrange the cups. Okay, Mick. Which cup contains the water? Furthest from me, closest to me, or in the middle? Nice and loud. You got it again. Give him a hand. Right. Mick, you're feeling good. Mick, it gets tougher. This time, whichever cup you guess first, I will pour the contents of that cup over my head. All right? But you're clapping. Thank you. All right. But if you are wrong, Mick, I'll pour the contents of the second cup that you guess over your head. And if you're wrong again, Hannah, I'll pour the contents of the third cup over the guy in the red sweatshirt for not clapping before. The guy who matters. I shall now mix up the cups. Psst, you're not really cups. Now they're all mixed up. All right, for real, Nick. You were paying attention? Which cup contains water? Furthest from me, closest to me, or in the middle? I'm sorry, what did you say? You said farthest from me? It's over here? You said farthest. Oh, I only take your first answer, Mick. Am I not playing fair? He means this one. You don't want to see that. Hello, Mick. Mick, do you think the water's in the cup in my left hand or in my right? Do you think it's here or here? Give Mick a hand for playing along. Thanks, Mick. Hey, Mick, thanks for playing along. I thought maybe we should leave a little gift for you. You want the water? Actually, not even the water. Do you remember the can, Mick? Watch the can. Let's all imagine that this can had never been crushed. Watch. What? Now let's all imagine that this can had never been opened, which means we need some magic breath. Can you see that on the camera? Is that showing up? Now let's all imagine it had never been emptied. We need to refill it. If it really did uncrush, it would look like this. If it really did reseal, it would sound like this. If it really did refill, it would taste like this. Come here, Meg. This is for you. Now wait. Come on. You're scared of it. Don't be scared. You can't have caffeine. Well, this has caffeine in it because this is Coke, so I was going to have you try it to prove it's real, but it's real, but will that much hurt you? You should, no, it will keep you up all night. Don't take it. Yeah, but you can keep it. It's not a trick can. Give Mick a hand for helping out. Run up there. Right there. Let's hear it for both of them. Give them both a big hand. Thank you, man. Thanks. What's your name? Kyla and Austin. Give them both another hand, Kyla and Austin. Now, some of you might not know this, but I also have gotten pretty good at reading minds, knowing what people are thinking. In fact, how about the lady in the back corner there holding the baby, that lady right there? Wave your hand for me, ma'am. I'm going to ask you a yes or no question. I'm going to know what you are thinking. Do you find me extremely handsome, yes or no? Yes, she's telling the truth. She has to. That's my wife. So that's my wife and baby. Everybody go, aww. Yeah, get a close up. That's Hudson. Hudson is 7 months old. He just had his first Christmas, so he's pretty excited to be out all night with you guys. So, all right. So, I have actually found, though, when I ask what people are thinking, if I just ask somebody to name a word, a lot of times I hear the same thing. I'll hear like dog, house, tree, cat, car, things like that. So to make it more interesting, I have brought just some, let's try it with somebody before we go into this. Let's see. All right, on the front, stay there. What's your name?
Kellen.
Kellen, I want you to think of any word in the English language, but don't say it out loud yet. Do you have it?
Yeah.
Kellen, if I have you name the word, and then I'm able to reach in and pull out a piece of paper with your word on it, would that be amazing?
Yes.
Pretty amazing. Kellen, what word are you thinking of? Pod?
Pie.
Pie?
Yes.
Pie. Inside here, I have a piece of paper with the word pie on it. Somewhere in this dictionary. There you go. Thank you. It's a gift. No. Now, I can't really read minds, Kellen. It's okay. But, you know, like I said, I often do hear the same words, so I thought we could mix it up a little bit. I brought some random books with me, and I'm going to need a little bit of help with this, but let's just see what I have. I have the Big Book of Silly Jokes. This is the kind of thing I like, lots of little knock-knock jokes, things like that. Where's Brad? Brad, our MC, is he? Brad, can you just be ready to come up here, Brad, in a moment? I'll have you come up in anything I need. All right, in just a little bit, I'll have you come up. And I have some, actually, I have a mystery novel. Anybody like to read those kind of things? All right. You're not going to have to come up. So some of you want to come up, some of you don't want to. But did you raise your hand? All right. What's your name? Izzy. Hold on to that book. All right. I also have a book written by our speaker who's coming on after me, Greg Speck. Who wants to hold on to one of his books? Maybe somebody different, somebody over here. How about the yellow shirt? This book is, yeah, come on. This book is Sex, It's Worth Waiting For. So there you go. That's what it is. No, I don't think he wrote this one. I picked this one up at the Goodwill store. This is, this is one of those romance novels. Yeah. Look at that. They had me pose for the cover, so. Yeah, no. So I need someone just to hold on to this. How about, are you a good reader in the third row there? All right. Toss that to you. All right, so very good. Let's try. I need someone quickly. Would you come up and just real quick stand right here for me? What's your name?
Caitlin.
Caitlin, I'm going to flip through here, and I just want you to say stop. We're just going to get a random stop right there. Tell me what page you stopped on, nice and loud. 70. All right, so page 70, would you turn to page 70 in your book? You could sit down, thank you for helping. Turn to page 70 in your book, and you have Greg's book, our speaker. Would you turn to page 70 in his book? Tell me when you're there. You got it? And you're at page 70 in the cheesy romance novel? All right, good. Would you look at the first word on your page, on page 70, and memorize it? Do you have it? And I want you to look at the first, and by the way, don't look at like the title or the heading, the first word of like a paragraph, like a regular sentence. Does that make sense? Don't look at any headings or titles. First word of the first sentence. All right, you both got that? Good. In our mystery novel, who's got the mystery novel? You can turn to any page in the entire book. We're going to make it random, all right? Just open anywhere. You got a page? And on that page, I want you to pick any word. But you know what? Don't pick a small word like a, an, or the. The bigger the word, the harder it is for me. So a nice big word, lots of syllables. Can you find something? Did you find one? Close the book. Just keep that word in your mind, all right? I'm going to see if I can figure it out here. I have my marker in here. All right. I want you to think of the first letter of your word. Are you thinking of it? It's a big word. Lots of syllables, huh? I'm thinking the first letter is S. Is it an S? What was it? Wait. Are you thinking of your word? Is the first letter of yours an S? It is? Is it two syllables? Does it end with an I-N? I think it ends with an I-N-G. Does it end with an I-N-G? For the first time, in a nice loud voice, what was your word? Swinging. Swinging. And you opened any page, looked at any word. Let me see if I can. I'm thinking you got several. What was your word?
Candlestick.
Candlestick. You opened any page. Candlestick. Candlestick. Actually, you know what? This is a. These are souvenirs for you guys. Let me come out here. All right, this is for you, Mr. Swinging. I'll take the book back. All right, let me trade you for yours. Thank you there. Now we still have Greg's book over here. You still have the book? Did you read it? Not yet. All right, now you look at the first word on page 70. First word in a paragraph, right? It's some kind of a number, right? What? Hold on, let me just write down what I think I don't know if this is like a license plate or. I'm just going to show you what I have. Is it like a. Does this mean anything to you? No? It's like a license plate or something? Wait a second. Who has my dictionary? You do. Turn to page 258. Does it go that high? It does. Are there two columns?
Yeah.
Go to the left-hand column. Are there lots of words defined in that column?
Not a ton.
That's okay. We only need the first one. The first bold word that you come to, the first word. Do you have it?
Yes.
Say it out loud. Is that the left column?
No, you couldn't. Sorry. It's not your.
It's your?
Yes.
What word were you thinking of? Your. Nice. There you go. I'll trade you. Thank you. That's our speaker's book. I never even read it. That's awesome. Hey, Brad. Where's Brad? Oh, come on up. You guys give him a hand for coming up here. Brad, I'm wandering around. Where's my joke book? That's what I'm looking for. All right. Brad, did you ever dream of doing stand-up comedy?
Never.
All right. Here's a microphone. Here's a joke book. You got 15 minutes. No. You're a youth pastor. It would be no problem. But actually, what I would like you to do, just take the book and open to any page. Look at the very first word printed on that page in the corner. Got it?
Got it?
All right. Perfect. I want you to back up here because I'm going to attempt to get your word. And let's do this. Would you do me a favor? Do not look at the screens, okay? Because I'm going to write down what I think it is. And I'm going to maybe ask you some questions. I want you to think of your word in all capital letters. Can you do that? So if you're thinking of your word in all capital letters, would the first letter have like a vertical line and some horizontal lines? All right. And let's go all the way to the end of your word. If you were to do that, is it another letter in all capitals? Would it have a horizontal line and a vertical line? Okay. Okay, I'm just going to go with this. Let me ask you some questions about this word, and I just want you to answer honestly. You can use the microphone if you want there. Brad, is this something that you do?
Frequently.
Okay. I think I'm on the right track. Is this something that you do pretty often?
Correct.
That would be what frequently is. All right. How often would you say you do this?
Daily.
Is it planned sometimes or just happen?
Both, yeah, spontaneous and
all right,
planned.
Good. So is this something that you would typically do alone or when you're with people?
That also happens. Both of those things happen.
Okay.
Sometimes alone, often with people.
Okay. Yeah. And I know you work with a lot of youth, and you know they might have a lot of questions about dating and relationships. So would you recommend this as something to do on a first date?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And the second and the third date.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Are you married?
Did you write poop on there?
No, I did not.
Okay.
No. No, it's. I think I got your word. Let me ask this: have you ever done this and it had like a certain aroma involved?
Yes, very aromatic, fragrancy.
Okay.
Kind of, yes,
last question. Please answer honestly. Have you ever done this and it gotten a little messy?
Especially when I was younger. Yes, that would be true.
Hold that with both hands and just tell the audience if I got your word correct. Did I get your word?
He did get my word correct. Yes.
Yes. And what was your word?
May I show it to them?
Yes.
It was eat.
It was eat. Yes. Give him a hand for helping out. Thank you, Mr. Brad.
I should feel humiliated, shouldn't
no,
I?
No, that's
yeah,
nothing
that's
wrong with eating. You just... We'll save that one for after I'm gone. Have that conversation later. So thank you, Brad, for helping out. We're going to try something that's actually brand new in what I do, and have a couple of glasses and a brand new deck of cards. In fact, they are factory sealed. See if we can take these off and come on up here. Check those out, Mick. Make sure, are they still sealed? Just verify that for the audience. The seal has never been broken. Sticker still complete and intact. Good. And we're going to see that as I open the cards, but I like to use a brand new sealed deck for this. For those of you who've ever opened a deck of cards and threw the box on the floor, you know that the cards come in order. Can we get a nice shot of this? We have jokers, and the spades are always first, and then there's the hearts, ace through, king, and then they go in reverse, the diamonds, and then all the way on down to the clubs, and sometimes they have these extra cards, okay? So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and take out 10 of them. Ace through 10. Does the camera see that? This is what you call new deck order. Not going to tamper with them. I'm not going to touch them once they are placed in the glass. In fact, I'm going to isolate them so that they cannot be tampered with. Now we also have an ace through 10 in our red cards. But these we are not going to leave in new deck order. I need someone just to give me a hand with these for a moment. Someone who maybe not done anything yet that wants to. How about in the hat there? You want to come on up? What's your name? Jake, you can just stand right there. I'd like you to do, Jake, is take those and mix them up. Mix them up, Jake, and as best you can. Give them a nice shuffle. You can do overhand like this, or got him there, Jake. And give him one more cut, so not even you know what order they're in. Perfect. Jake, you're amazing. Everybody give Jake a hand for helping out. Now, Jake did that face down, so not even he would know what order they're in. Not going to tamper with the order. Going to leave them in the exact order that he gave them to me in. All right, so we have a 5 in the front, 8 ace, and on all the way across. All right, so we're going to try one more person from the audience. But all right, what's your name? Jacob. Jacob, I'm going to go along with my finger. I want you just to shout out stop. Right there? Perfect. Let's see what we have. Jacob stopped me on the 4 of hearts. The one he stopped me on gets turned around and placed in the exact position that it was a moment ago, only it's now reversed, in the middle of the order that we just had shuffled. These cards get placed into this glass. You might remember over here, ace through 10, new deck order. They haven't been touched. Nothing in this hand, nothing here. Get a nice shot of this. You might notice that now in the very front is a 5, which means it matches this side. Underneath this 5, which you shuffled, is an 8. Underneath this 5 is an 8. Underneath this 8 is an ace. Over here is an ace. Under the aces are 10s. Under the 10s are 9s. Under the 9s are 3s. Under this 3 is a card, which is reversed. Exactly where you told me to do it over here is now also a card reversed. In fact, you had me reverse the 4 of hearts. This one is indeed the 4 of spades. In fact, if we keep looking, we have the 6s, the 2s, and the 7s. Everyone, thank you for helping. When I was your age, I was just getting into magic. I was into sports and all kinds of other things, but my pastor actually showed me a magic trick when I was 7 years old, and I kind of thought it was interesting like a lot of kids, but as I grew a little older, I started doing a little bit more with it and started to have fun with it, and my dad once, I remember, he took me to this magic shop, and I looked up on the shelf, and there I saw it, this magic prop. In fact, I'm going to unveil it now. Yes. That's about how I felt. When I saw that, I said, hey, man, if I had a magic prop like that, that would make me a magician. That's kind of like somebody saying, hey, if I had a piano, I would be a musician. Or if I had a football, I would instantly become a quarterback. See, all these years later, I don't usually use props like that. I use bowling balls and regular books and unsealed cards, things like that. But back then, I thought it was all in the prop. If I had that, then I would have what it takes to be a magician. You know, it was also about that time that I was being discipled and learned what it meant to be a Christian, a follower of Jesus Christ, because there were so many ideas floating around, like, man, if I just read my Bible enough, that will make me a Christian. Or, hey, if I just go to church on Sundays with my parents, that will make me okay with God. Or I'd see my parents give money to the church. Hey, that's what it takes to be a believer, what it means to be a follower of Jesus Christ, to have him transform your life. But you know what? I found out all those things were wrong. What does gospel mean? Gospel really means good news. And as I've traveled around, I find out that there's so many people that really have no idea what the good news really is. So using this magic trick that I got when I was 14 years old, I want to share with you the good news that changed my life. You know what? Let's look at these scars for just a moment. Look at this purple one in the next few moments. As you look at this purple one, I want this to remind you of God. Everything you know about God to be true from his word, the Bible. Look at this red one. As you look at this, I want this to remind you of people like you and me. You know, when God first created you, he did it so that he could have a relationship with you, so that he could be your God and you could be his child. But you know, as we find out in life, we all choose to do things that kind of separate us from having that kind of a relationship with God. Some of you might know that word is sin. And what is that middle letter of the word sin? It's I. It's when we say, I want to do what I want to do, God, not what you would have me do. You know, each and every day we are tempted to go our own way instead of God's way. In fact, in the book of Romans, it says, all of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We don't measure up to his holy standard, no matter how many good things we do, no matter how hard we try. In fact, I have another scarf that might represent our sin. In fact, we've all seen this symbol like on a pirate ship or in a bottle of detergent. If you were to see this on a bottle of detergent, you know this means poison, warning, danger, death, stay away. Well, you know, the Bible says the same thing about our sin. It says warning, danger, death. It says the wages of sin is death. With my kids that are a little bit older, they were asking what a wage is. I said, it's like your payment when you get what you deserve. Like when you're done working, you go up to your boss and say, I'd like my wages. Show me the money. Well, the Bible says when we sin, we earn punishment. It's kind of like a criminal in a courtroom stands before the judge and he passes out the punishment. God is a holy, righteous judge. And we have people like you and me. We have punishment for our sins. And we have a God who loves you so, so much. But Scripture also teaches that he's a holy God. And he hates sin. Sometimes people say this. I have some good news and I have some bad news. First, we get the bad news in that verse. The wages of sin is death. Nobody likes to hear that. But then comes the second part. It says, but the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord. The gift. Just like that very well-known verse some of you might know, for God so loved the world that he gave. He gave us a gift. We all like gifts. Imagine you're a child, you know, going to a birthday party. You have the perfect gift. You take it to your friend. You say, here, I got this for you. What if your friend would say, you know what? I don't want to open that. Let's go play outside. You'd feel bad or rejected or hurt. Or maybe it's Christmas. There's something under the tree and your mom or dad says, this is for you. We got it for you because we love you. You say, I want to open that. I'm going to go up to my room. That would never happen. At least not in my house. But how does God feel when so many people say, you know what, God? I'm not interested in your gift. I'm just going to live my life my way. See, God's gift was the most expensive gift of all time. How much did it cost? It cost the life of his son. You know, I don't love anybody enough to give up my son Hudson for. But that's what God did. Jesus Christ, he came to earth as that baby in a manger. He grew up, he showed us how to live, how to love, how to serve others. But then he gave his life in our place. He was the only one that could do that because he was the only one that was without sin. He did not deserve the punishment, but he took it willingly upon himself. And you know, he rose again, proving he said he was who he said he was, the Son of God. And you know, when we do open that gift, when we say, yes, God, I don't want to go my way, I want to go your way. In the Bible it says repent. Repent means to change your mind, to turn from your sin and turn to God. When we come to him like he asks us to, repenting of our sin and turning to him and placing him in charge of our life, something wonderful happens. We can get connected to God because of one name. Tell me, what is that name? Jesus. Yeah, that's worth clapping for. That's the gospel. Yeah. Yeah, you know what? I got this simple magic trick when I was with it, like I said, when I was a kid, but this truth, it never changes. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. Jesus wasn't saying that because he was trying to exclude anyone. He was saying, hey, I'm the Son of God. I'm giving my life for you. Pay attention, because I am your only chance. Clap your hands if you believe that tonight. Thank you. That's such an important part of my life, so I wanted to share that with you. But I want to do something else kind of fun right now. I have some youth leaders, their names written down here, and they're from some of our different churches. So I want Justin from Springbrook to come up here. Where's Justin? Is he in the house? There he is, way back there. Sergio from Grace Elgin. Corey from Carrie Grace. All right. And Katie from Crystal Lake Free, right here, EB Free Church. All right, so you're Corey. All right, come on over, guys. How you doing? Sergio, stand right here for me, Sergio. And you can stand right there, Corey, and you are?
Justin.
Justin, you want to stand down there at the end? You can stand right here. All right, and you're Katie. Awesome. Yeah, that's good. No, come back here. Come back here. That's good. All right. I have something fun planned for you guys. Thanks for coming up, all of you. Here, let me go ahead and get these cards. And would you go ahead and just take a look at those? Make sure those are all different and everything. Good. Normal? All right. Good, 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 good. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and put some rubber bands around these cards because I was doing this recently and somebody dropped the cards and it was kind of a mess. So I'm going to toss these to you in a moment. And what I would like you to do is to look at a card, all right? Don't look at the ace. That's too easy. That's on the front. Just lift up, look at one card. Oh, don't watch.
Oh.
All right? Yeah. No, you'll be... You're fine now. You're fine now, Corey. But Sergio's going to be looking at a card, but you're going to get a card as well. And Katie, you're going to get a card. Justin, you're going to get a card. But I only want you to see your card. I don't want you to see each other's cards because sometimes people get nervous in front of a group, and if you've seen multiple cards, you might forget. So when you get the deck, again, don't look at the ace. That's too easy. That happens to be the one on the front. Lift up. Look at one card in the middle. The first one you see, memorize it. All right? Very good. Sergio, we're going to start with you. Make sure the rubber banded here. And, oh, you know what? Before we do this, Sergio, would you do me a favor? Would you just try that on? Awesome. Actually, you know what? Here we go. There's one for you. There's one for you. Katie, here's one for you. All right. And Justin, yours is back here. There we go. All right. Oh, yeah. You guys do what I do, all right? Justin, pay attention, like this. Here we go. Help me lead the crowd. Everybody, do it with them. All right, good job, guys. Sergio, take the cards. Don't watch in there, Corey. Look at your first card. Find one in there. Did you memorize it? Memorize it. Pass it on down there. And Corey, go ahead and look at a card. Memorize it. Don't let me see it. First one in the middle there. Anywhere in the middle. Pass it on down here to Katie. Katie, look at any card in the middle, first one you see, then pass it on down there to Justin. I'm not watching. Justin, did you get the card yet? Yep, that's fine. Did you get one? All right, Justin, if you would, toss them back here to me. Don't glare at me. You're taking this cowboy and anything a little too serious there. All right. Very good. So you each have a card? Very good. In a moment, I'm going to name four cards. If I name your card, I don't want any reaction. You are solid. Even if I don't name your card, don't give me any reaction. I'll name four cards. I want your best poker face. Jack of hearts. Five of clubs. Nine of diamonds. Four of spades. It's almost time to react. If I named your card, take off your hat now. What was your card, Katie? Jack? Jack of hearts? That was the first one. Yes, take off your hat. Everybody give them all a hand for helping out. There you go. There's one, two, three. That's all right. High five for you. All right. Let's get those cards passed out. If my ushers could come up, our college kids, they're going to be handing out everyone in the audience four cards. We're going to try and experiment together. And actually, I need four of them. Hand four to me, because I'm going to lead them. All right, very good. Everyone in the audience right now, over the next few moments, you're going to be handed four cards. Hold on to them, because you're going to get to try something interactive, all right? So get your four cards, and then we will continue in a moment. It's okay if you look at your card. You should have four different cards. If they're not different, you can trade with someone. If you have four cards, raise your hand. Let me see how many. Looks like we're working back there a little bit. Leaders, you can take 4 cards as well. We should have enough. You guys done? Is that it? Raise your hand if you have cards in the back. Let me see. Everybody have cards? Are we done, leaders? We good? All right. I think we'll roll with it. Hey, by the way, if you want to let me know what you thought of the show, you can find me on Instagram or Twitter at Tim That's Amazing. Tim That's Amazing, all right? Very good. All right, let's try this. Everyone take your 4 cards. Hold them out in front of you. If you are able to follow directions, you're gonna find something amazing, all right? But you got to follow along every step. We'll take our 4 cards, only 4, not 3, not 5. I don't know how many you got. Everybody should have 4. Hold them in a landscape position right out in front of you with 2 fingers on the front, 1 thumb on the back, and then the other 2 fingers on the other side with 1 thumb on the back. The cards should be facing away from you, just like mine are. Now let me demonstrate before you try it. What I'm going to do is rip these cards in half, but I'm going to take my time so that I get as nice of a tear as I can. So do your very best to tear all the cards in half. Do it now. Go ahead, tear your cards in half. Some of you are done already. Fantastic. Now take the cards and put either half on top and hold them all down in front of you face down. Now, of course, your cards to begin with were in some kind of random order. None of us would have any way of knowing that. We're going to learn what cutting the cards means. Watch me. Cutting the cards is taking any amount from the top in a block and moving them to the bottom. So what I'd like you to do, go ahead and cut your cards from the top to the bottom, a block of cards. It could be 1 card, 2 cards, 3 cards, 4 cards, whatever you decide. Go ahead and cut them. If you've done that, say, I've done it. If you'd like, you can cut them one more time. Move a block from the top to the bottom so you have them in a completely random arrangement. Hold them just like that. We're moving on to our next step. Take the top 3 cards, which if they're face down, you don't even know what they are. Take them and put them anywhere in the middle of your cards. Do that now. Now, after you've done that, take the top card. Do not look at it, but I want you to sit on it because you are going to need to get at that in a little bit. And I don't want you to get it mixed up with your other cards. Now, take the top 2 cards. Put them somewhere in the middle. Now, take the top card, hold it up in the air. If you would like, you can exchange it with a neighbor. Some of you have exchanged it. Some of you have chosen to hold on to that card. Doesn't matter. Put it somewhere in the middle. In the middle. Now, if you've had a really bad week, I don't want you to do anything right now. If you've had a so-so week, pick up one card from the top. If you've had a pretty good week, pick up two cards from the top. If you've had a fantastic week, pick up three cards from the top. 0, 1, 2, or 3, and hold that many cards in the air. And toss them away. You do not need them anymore. Now, some of you threw away nothing. Some of you traded. Some of you cut two times. Some of you cut one time. It's getting pretty random. We're going to now try something all together, though. We're going to go through our days of the week, starting with Sunday. Take the top card, put it on the bottom, and say Sunday.
Sunday.
Take the next card from the top, move it to the bottom, and say Monday.
Monday.
Next card from the top to the bottom, and say Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Next card to the bottom, and say Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Next card, say Thursday. Next card from the top to the bottom, say Friday.
Friday.
Next card to the bottom and say Saturday.
Saturday.
That completes our week. We are moving to the last step. Take the top card, put them on the bottom, and say they love me.
They love me.
Take the next card now on top, throw it away, and say they love me not.
They love me not.
Take the next card from the top, put it to the bottom, and say they love me. Take the next card, throw it away, and say, they love me not.
Love me.
Next card to the bottom, they love me.
They love,
they love me not. Keep doing that until you have one card left. Hold up that card. Some of you have shuffled. Some of you have traded with a neighbor. Some of you have chosen to throw cards away. Some of you haven't. Look at that card that you're holding. Now find the card that you are sitting on and see if it is a perfect match. Did you get a match? Ha! Brad, come on up. Hey, you guys are awesome. Did you have a good time? You guys have a great time tonight. God bless all you guys. Thank you very much.